Oh, God, Tink, I thought it was the cops again.
Just your friendly neighbourhood milkman.
You're a real good mate, you know that? Would have been sprung for sure last night.
Yeah, well, it was a close one. You still might. You hungry?
Oh, you bet. Hey, where'd you get to last night?
Well, after I gave the cops a slip, I went round to my brother's. Talked about that job. You reckon it's a go.
And?
You gonna do it?
Huh. Best of luck.
Yeah, well, I'm getting short on cash myself. I'm getting sick of this dump. So after I do the job, I'm gonna piss off up north.
Reckon I might take over your lease for you.
Even this place is out of your category.
Yeah, you're not wrong.
So what are you gonna do?
Oh, don't worry about me. I can look after myself. Are you really sure about this job?
Yeah. It's all fixed up. Ray's your last to leave. He's going to close the safe and he's going to lock it. And he's going to fix the alarm so it looks like it's buggered up. All I've got to do is walk in, take the money and walk out. Sure you don't want any of it?
Look, I already told you, no way.
Tell you what. When I piss off, I'll take you with me. Just get you out of town.
What do you mean?
You can ride with me far as you like.
Stick it.
What do you mean?
Look, you're already paying for me food and me smokes. Now you want to pull a job, take all the risks and take me along as a passenger. I don't bludge off me mates like that.
Oh, shut up, will you? So what are you going to do? We'll hang around here till the cops come back? Well?
I guess I'll have to come in with you.
Are you sure?
Well, like you say, got nothing better to do, have I? Fence.
I told you our Mother Peters here doesn't need job. Oh, thank goodness for that. I'd have to crouch here another minute longer. These legs will never work again.
Come on, you old crook. How long have we got till he comes back again?
It's about an hour. There's plenty of time. Come on, Maxie, love. Let's go finish that fence.
Buggers aren't going to be too pleased tomorrow when the boss tells them there's no pay for them.
Yeah, Ray reckons they hate his cats. Come to think of it, we're really doing them a favour. Give them a good excuse to lynch him.
Hope his insurance is paid up. Hey, do you want me to take this?
No, I tell you what, you take the torch. We better get going too. We've been lucky this far. We'll push it.
Okay. Ow!
Hell, Maxie, what's the matter?
Oh, wouldn't you know it, Wentworth, here I come.
What have you done?
My ankle. I think I've busted it. Think you better hurry up and get the hell out of here. You reckon it's busted?
No, just twisted.
Oh, geez, I'm sorry, Tink. But listen, I can look after myself. Why don't you just get the bloody hell out of here?
You reckon I'm going to run off and leave you here like a sitting duck? I'm not your family, Maxie. Either you get up and walk out of here with me or we'll both wait and the cops pick us up. We're in this together all the way. Right?
Right.
Nearly home and host.
Listen, Tink, why don't you and me head up north for a while? We could go a long way on your bike.
Come on, love, we've been through that. You'll be all right. And we'll see each other as soon as the pressure's worn off a bit.
Likes to do nothing right.
Shh. Okay, love. I think you can let your breath out now. Just go around the other side. How's your foot?
Well, terrific. Look, just get me to the bike, all right?
Okay, let's go.
Hey, you two!
I'm right there!
Come on, we can't stop now. They're not gonna put me...
Little Maxie never hurt anybody.
I don't know, love. I just don't know.
I'm gonna be wrong about her. She didn't want to come back here. She wouldn't have done that. I'm gonna be wrong, B.
Lizzie, do you feel like talking about it? I'm sorry, I know how close you and Maxine were.
What happened, Mrs. Reynolds?
There was a payroll robbery. Maxine was shot trying to escape.
Did you know about it?
Yes, we did.
Well, why didn't you tell me? I had to hear it from a bloody radio station. Why didn't you tell me, Mrs. M?
I'm sorry, Lizzie, but with things as they are, I felt that you were under enough stress. It was for your own good.
For my own good? And I had to hear it from a bloody stranger.
This letter came this morning from Maxine.
You read it to me, love.
Dear Lizzie, this is just to let you know I don't forget my old mates. I know you thought I must be bonkers breaking out.
But I reckon I would have gone crazy if I'd stayed inside much longer. See, there's so much I want to do. But if I'm cooped up inside, I'll never get me chance. This time, though, I'm going to do it the right way. Get a job, find a nice place to live. Who knows, I might even find myself a bloke and get married. Guess stranger things have been known to happen, eh? I don't want you to worry about me, Lizzie. I reckon I'm on the right path now. Being broken by yourself is the hardest part. But now I met this real beaut girl and she's called Tinkerbell. I reckon she's going to be a real good mate. But don't worry, I won't forget all my mates in Wentworth. Just thought if I do get married, I could have kids. Hope the first one's a girl. If she is, I reckon I'll call her Lizzie. Anyway, and that's me lot for now. I really am going to miss you all. Especially you, Lizzie. I love you. Maxine. Oh. Oh. Oh.